Bill Telepan. Welcome back to Telepan TV. We're going to start off. The next four videos we're going to do for you are going to be soups. Given it's the winter time, it's a great time to have soups. It's also great to have them around if you want to just have a little lunch, or you can make these and take them to work for lunch. There's enough to feed a family of four for sure, easily. A good meal with like maybe a little salad, some crusty bread, you know what I'm saying? So today we're going to start off by doing chickpeas. Actually, this is one that's on the menu right now at Telepan. It's going to be a chickpea soup with some rosemary croutons, and we're going to have a little Swiss chard in there. So let me get you started here. So right now, I have going in a pot here a little onion and garlic. It's been going for several minutes. And to that, we're going to add a little canned tomato. So for the home recipe, it's about, you know, one clove of garlic and one of those small cans of whole tomato. Squeeze them out really well, chop them up so they're almost dry. And you're just gonna cook that in the oil and with the onion and garlic for about 5 minutes or so, just till they get a little dry. Now, the chickpeas I've soaked overnight. It's better to use dry chickpeas for this, but if you can only get canned chickpeas, what I would do is just cook the stock down with the tomato and garlic for about 20 minutes, and then add the canned chickpeas to it. But since we're going to do the cooked chickpeas that we soaked, we're going to add them to the pot now. And we're going to add 8 cups of stock to that. Water, chicken stock, or if you're a vegetarian, you use vegetable stock. So I got some vegetable stock going here. So we're going to let that come up to a boil and simmer until they get tender. And then now what I'm going to do is we're going to add some garnish to it. So I started cooking I got some leek, some celery, some carrot. Got a little celery root if you'd like to it. We just cook these together. Just a little olive oil, pinch of salt, cover them for about 5 or 7 minutes. Now we're going to make the croutons. So we're going to take the rosemary. You need about a teaspoon of rosemary. I'm gonna sprinkle a salt into that. And the salt helps to bring out the oils in it, just like if you're mashing garlic. So it helps draw out more flavor. We're just gonna put it back into the, maybe about like a teaspoon. I'm gonna mix that with a little extra virgin olive oil. Stir that up. I got a little ciabatta bread here where we make some croutons for that. So you can get little rolls, ciabatta rolls if you want, and use them. You could use any kind of bread really. Sourdough bread works great. And just get them nice and thin like so. And the great thing is the bread, if you have some extra bread just laying around, you could use day old or, you know, a couple days old on the bread and just use those up for croutons. We do a lot at home where we get some bread and if we don't use it all up, I'll freeze it up. You know, for if I want to use croutons, or if I want to use it for breadcrumbs too, it's a good idea to save some there. Sprinkle salt onto those, and just dry them out in like a 350 oven. Depending on the chickpea, after about a 30 minutes to 45 minutes, check if the seeds are tender. These are ready to go. Turn them off. I'm gonna bring it over here to the blender. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take some of the chickpeas out, about half of them. And we're gonna puree them with some of the stock. Not a pureed soup, but the pureed chickpeas will give it a little more viscosity, a little more thicker, a little more, you know, satisfying. Now I'm gonna puree them until they're, you know, every time I start a blender, I always go, just start it slowly, get it going, and then. So you wanna puree these till they're really pureed smooth, so it'll take a few minutes. Also slow it down on you. So it's very important to keep a towel on top of the surface just in case it does spill out. You don't want to burn your hand. You want to hold the top down. So here we go. We got some thick soup here. And we're just gonna add this to the liquid here. I'm gonna add a little more in here to sort of get some of that out of there. Keep doing that until it all comes out. Alright, so. I'm gonna bring that back over to the stove here. And we'll add our vegetable to that. The other thing I like to add is some greens to it, so give that nice Italian touch. So I have some Swiss chard here. Black kale or Tuscan kale is also very good. So you want to sort of tear it up and then chop it very finely, because you don't want any of these long strands of the greens come out. You want it nice and finely chopped, so just like that. So it came up back to a simmer. We'll add this back into it, some of this into it. Stir it in slowly. And just like all soups, it's great to make it a day ahead. It could be a fast soup to make if you have everything ready to go. So let's check our croutons. Nice and crispy. That's nice, good consistency. That's crouton on top. The thing I like to do is add a little more oil to it to sort of give a little flavor. Break that up. Put that in there. There you have it. Delicious. Chickpea soup, a little rosemary croutons, some Swiss chard. Thanks for watching Telepan TV. We'll see you next time.